A very good morning, dear children. Welcome back to the class. So let's start. Take out your workbook. So children, let's start the class. Before starting with our today's topic, children, we'll just give a quick recap of the topics which we have. So children, let's start the class. Before starting with our workbook, children, we'll just give a quick recap of the topics which we have studied. The terms earlier and later, shorter. So we have learned the meaning of these words and where to use these words, right? Next, parts of the day. There are different parts of the day, right? Morning, noon, afternoon, evening, then your midnight. So there are different parts of the day, and during different parts of the day, children, we do different activities. Third, sequencing the events happening in a day. So children, sequencing the events, that means you have to start with the first work what you do, then you have to arrange in order, that is first you have done this, then second you have done, first you woke up in the morning, second you have brushed your teeth, third you took shower, then you took your breakfast, children, then you got ready for the school, right? So you are doing the work in order. So I am arranging in order. That means first work is waking up in the morning. So this is called sequence. Arranging the events in order. Clear? So children, now take out your workbook. Okay, before starting with our workbook, let's do one activity. Children, as you know, AM means antimeridian and PM means prime meridian and the duration of both. You know that antimeridian and prime meridian comes under which duration? That is from midnight, the time between midnight and noon is what? Antimeridian. And the time between noon and midnight is your prime meridian, that is PM. So this is the duration, right? So identify which of the following activity is done during AM and PM. Having breakfast. You have breakfast in the morning, right? And morning is what? AM. Anti-meridian. Going to school. Going to school is what, children? AM or PM? First, you try yourself. Answer to this question. Yes, AM. Third, coming back from school. So, coming back from school, children, when do you come from back from school? Afternoon, right? So the time between noon and midnight, between noon and midnight, what comes, children? Afternoon and evening, right? So afternoon and evening is what? PM. So coming back from the school, we come back in afternoon. So children, it is PM. Clear? So now let's start with our workbook. These three questions were done, children. First three questions were done. So the next, let's start with four. The time at 12 noon. So children, the time at 12 noon is what? 12 noon means 12 o'clock during the daytime. So it is your, is it morning? No. Is it midnight? No. Is it afternoon? No. It is midday. 12 noon is also called as midday. Number 5, what do you say to your parents when you get up in the morning? Children, when you get up in the morning, what do you say to your parents? Whether it is good morning, good afternoon, good evening or good night. When we wake up in the morning, we say good morning. So the correct answer is good morning. With morning, children, we say good morning. Okay, when it is afternoon, we say good afternoon. When it is evening, we say good evening. And when it is night, children, we say good night. Okay? Number 6, the sun rises in the... The sun rises in the... Children, during which part of the day sun rises? We see sunrise in the morning, right? So the correct answer is morning. C. You can write the option here, and if you want, you can write the spelling in these blanks also. Morning, okay? Next, 7, fill in the blanks. The time between 12 midnight and 12 noon is called what? So children, in a day there are 24 hours, right? There is 24 hours. So you know that it is divided into 12 and 12 hours. 12 hours and 12 hours. Time between 12 midnight. Time between 12 midnight. Children, I'm not writing the complete spelling. 12 midnight and 12 noon. The time between 12 midnight and 12 noon is what? Is your, what do we call? Morning. What do we call? Morning. Okay? What do we call? Morning. And how do we write, children? It is what, AM or PM? It is AM. It is AM. Okay? When we start from 12 midnight, it is AM. But when we start, when we ask the time between 12 noon and 12 midnight, children, when it is from 12 noon, when it starts from 12 noon, children, then it is what? What it is? What part, which part of the day it is, children? It is afternoon. We call it as afternoon. Afternoon and children, evening, isn't it? So this is 12 hours. This is 12 hours. Midnight to 12 noon is 12 hours. And 12 noon to midnight is 12 hours. So 12 plus 12 is 24. So 24 hours makes one day. So children, the time between 12 noon and 12 midnight, what part of the day come? Which part of the day? Afternoon and evening. And we say it as prime meridian, that is prime meridian, that is PM. Clear? So the time between 12 midnight and 12 noon is what? This. 12 midnight and 12 noon is what? Morning. It is morning time. So you can write the spelling MORNING, morning. Clear? Next, number 8. Earlier or dash are words used for events happening at different times. So earlier or, which two words we have studied? Earlier or later. Are words used for events happening at different times. Number 9. The time 12 o'clock at night is what? What do we call? The time which is 12 o'clock at night, we call it midnight. And the time 12 o'clock during the daytime, children, what do we say? Your noon or midday, isn't it? So the answer is midnight. MIDNIGHT. You also learn the spellings, children. So let's move to next. Tick activities done earlier. You have to tick the activity which is done earlier and cross the activities done later. So the first activity, number 10, is what? Climbing up the rope. So when we start climbing, children, we always start from bottom, isn't it? This is a starting point and this child is in the end point, at the end point, right? So what is earlier? This is earlier. For she started from here. So this is earlier. So we'll give tick to earlier and cross to later. Clear? We'll give tick to earlier and cross to later. Number 11, finishing the race. So children, first, the car was here and then it reached the end point, right? Then, so this is earlier and this is later. First, it came here and then it reached your end point. Clear? So, here it comes. Earlier will be tick and later will be cross. 12th activity is what? Planting trees. Here you can see children are getting ready to preparing for planting the tree. So they are digging the soil, right? So for this, children, this is earlier. First they will dig. So this is earlier and then they have put inside the plant. So this is later. For earlier we will put tick and for later cross. Is it clear? You can do it along with me, children. Next, short answer questions 13. Take the activity which comes earlier. Which comes earlier, children? So you have to take the activity which comes earlier. Okay? So the first activity is what? Painting the wall. Now, which one is earlier? Can you see the rainbow colors here? Here they have put three colors, isn't it? And here you can see more than three colors, isn't it? So which one is earlier? This one is earlier. That means they completed three colors first and then they move to more than three, right? So this is earlier. So take the earlier one. Clear? Then number B. Filling water. Now you can see there are two buckets, right? When we start filling bucket, children, it start filling from the bottom, isn't it? First it complete the half. So this it was half completed first, then later the complete bucket was filled, isn't it? So this one is earlier. Hope so it is clear to you all, children. Then the next question, number 14. Arrange the following activities. Begin from what you do earlier. What you do earlier. So earlier means what comes first. So let's see what are the activities here. Wearing shoes, having lunch at school, wearing socks, going to school. So children, basically you are getting ready to go to school. So for that, you will wear shoes. For wearing shoes, children, you have to wear socks first. Isn't it? So number one, you are going to write socks. So you will write here, wearing socks. After wearing socks, children, what do we do? We wear shoes. Number two is wearing shoes. After wearing shoes, what we do? Yes, children, we go to school. Number three, go to school. Then having lunch at school. This is last, having lunch at school. So in this is arranged in order, that is in sequence, starting to the work which we have done last. Clear? This is a sequence. And what should be the sequence? The sequence should be begin from what you do earlier. So earlier means what comes first. We wear our socks first, then come shoes, then going to school, and then having lunch at school. Understood? Okay. So children, you can let's stop here. What you can do, children, you can do these questions at home, understand the questions, and if you find any difficulty, you can ask me. So before concluding, children, just let's do two of the questions, answer to this question. So children, let's answer to these questions. You think over these questions and do the answer in your copy. The first question is, Anil, after returning from school, he did two activities in the afternoon. In the afternoon, he did two activities. Can you say which activity is done later? Having lunch or washing hand? Among these two, which activity was done later? You write, find out the answer and write the answer in your copy, and we'll discuss the answer in our next class. Number two, Swapnil's mother asked him to do the following work. Can you say which work will take more time? Filling water in a bucket or filling water in a glass? So think over it, children, and answer to these questions. So that's all for today. Thank you so much.